here is a very short video on how to make a simple witch's broom. The materials that I have used are quite easy to find anywhere around, if you're in the parks or woods, or if you have some trees in your back garden. There are a lot of books and advice on which particular wood and branches to select and when to make these things, but we believe that real magic comes from within, and witches used whatever material were available to them in the first place, and if they had the luxury of picking specific item, then they will actually go for a particular wood. So we are going to start really simple from an empowered point of view and use the materials that we have, and that's what I've done. Found the material in my garden, which is a big willow tree. Okay, so let's begin. First of all, here are some pictures of the items that I've actually used. Bits of willow thin branches, which I've actually been collecting and just piled up. And there is also a large willow branch. It's about a meter and a half, or just about a meter long. And the materials that you're going to need, the craft items, are just a couple of small art and craft knives, or craft knives that you can find on any shops, and a ball of cotton thread. If you have metal wire, that'll be ideal as well. You'll also need some ribbons and decorative material afterwards. So the first thing to do is just to take the willow branch, the larger one, this is going to be your broom handle, and just clean it out a little bit if it doesn't look right. But if you wanted to leave it as it is, you can, or you can actually start making marks straight away. But in this particular example, I am cleaning out the branches, and you can see that the stages are being cleaned, and here is the end point. I personally like to use branches which have got interesting little features, and this particular one, it has got like a little tip and a little pointy sort of thing, so I'm using that. This part is the one that's going to go in to the actual broom itself, so the handle will be slightly thicker, and the broom part that's going to be buried into the brush part of it can be slightly smaller. So this is the one that's going to go into the brush. In this picture, you can see that I've collected bits that have fallen onto the ground, the dried bits. I've also got some fresh ones which I've just kind of pulled off the tree. As it's autumn, they're kind of, you know, you can see that they haven't got much leaves on them. So two slightly different textures which we'll use later. Well, take the dried out branches, clean them out, get rid of all the leaves, and have about a foot long. In fact, fold it, so you just actually make it double. Okay, and the next stage is to kind of hold it very tightly and tie a ball of, well, tie the cotton thread around it to keep it in place. So once this is done, insert it all the way in, and the little kind of feature helps it to kind of stop from going all the way in. You can now add some more thread and tie it tightly, and actually I would advise you to tie a little bit on the broom handle itself, just to kind of stop it from moving up and down. Now we come to the kind of fresh branches that I cut down. These are going to be added on top of the existing arrangement you've already made. It kind of hides the other bits that you've done, but it also gives it a fresher look from the outside. Doesn't make any difference magically, but it's a pretty thing just to look at as well. And here's the finished product. You know, you've added the fresh branches on top, the other ones are inside, folded, and the handle inserted. And now for some sort of trimmings, go to the end part of the broom and just cut out a nice clean line so that it's not sort of scraggy. And to finish off, you know, you can use ivy or some other decorative branches, and obviously ivy, as time passes, will fade, but you can always keep adding more and more ivy to it. And a final bit is just to add some ribbons, and I've just used a simple ribbon, a yellow ribbon here. But you may wish to use other kinds of ribbons, and to finish it off, continue the ribbon all along the broom handle. You can also add more ivy to it. And there's the finished product. You can see that the end is nicely trimmed, and the handle doesn't have to be straight. You can go for a nice exotic, slightly curved feature. It's really personal preference. Okay, so enjoy making the broom, and best of luck and good fortune as you use the broom.